it is considered the eco-friendly and also renewable material as well. This is the one of the key things. For the application, you know what? The mycelium-based composites, mostly it is lightweight, not so heavy. Mm-hmm. When we compare with the like a plastering material or gypsum plate material, this is, we show this is dominance property mm-hmm. of the mycelium-based composites.
I'm your host, Thirak Alsan, and welcome to Thailand Today. Now, in an earlier episode, we discussed the Zero Pollution Zebra Project, which is the making of zebra animal offerings via green initiatives. A main material used in making the zebra doll offering is mycelium, which has been hailed as the ultimate green material for the future. So what is it, and can it play a big role in creating a sustainable future? We are joined again by Dr. Nattawut Punyun from the Plant Microbe Interaction Research Team and the National Center for Genetic Engineering and Biotechnology, or BioTech. Swatika, and welcome back to the show. Now, in an earlier episode, we discussed about how mycelium is being used as the material mm-hmm. that is the main material for making zero pollution zebra. Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Can you give us a recap again? What is mycelium?
Okay, again. In terms of mycology, as one of the branching of microbiology to study of fungi at mushroom. Mm-hmm. So the mycelium, known as singulona, this is referred to root line structure okay. of the fungus mm-hmm. or a mushroom here. They form the fungal branching networks. For the mycelium, many mycelium, they mm-hmm. stick together until turn into the complicated next work. So that this is when we see on the agar paste, when we see the patterns, figure morphological characteristic, it look like a puffy cotton. Mm-hmm. Someone think about like a tiny fiber. And also, it seemed to be like a spider pattern that mm-hmm. I mentioned before. Sometimes, when we see in depth under a microscope, we can see different fungus resulting in the different pattern of mycelium, and also different counter based on each fungus or based on a mushroom.
So it's kind of like a network of fungal threads.
Yes.
Right?
A mass on the
cloth. It looks very similar to cotton. We'll have a look at it a little bit later. It's right in front of you. We'll take a look at it in a bit. But why was mycelium the go-to material for the Zero Pollution Zebra Project?
Okay. Exactly. One of the main thing is it's absolutely organic material. Because mycelium, if we use the microscope in high solution, we can see inside in cell wall. They compose of chitin and a little bit of protein mm-hmm. And glucan, like a small sugar. Mostly in mycelium, they contain chitin. Chitin, when they release them in the environmental or even to export in landfill, this is completely degradable as well. Mm-hmm. This is also similar property compared with the lignocellulose residue and also agriculture waste residue as well.
Now, it's also hailed as the ultimate green material for the future. Mm-hmm. What properties make it such good material?
For the one thing is it should be completely self-degradable. Mm-hmm. Secondly, it is considered the eco-friendly and also renewable material as well. This is the one of the key things. For the application, you know what? The mycelium-based composites, mostly it is lightweight, not so heavy. Mm-hmm. When we compare with the like a plastering material or gypsum plate material, this is, we show this is dominance property mm-hmm. of the mycelium-based composites.
So it's more, it's lightweight compared to other materials that could be used to make the same products.
And one of the best things, all of the innovative mycelium-based products or any composites, we, again, we can turn any agricultural waste or even biomass, turn it into the high-end product at the value-added products.
Okay.
This is also in terms of economic scale. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Now, can it be found anywhere? Where can mycelium be found? And it, can you make it in Thailand?
Yes, of course. For the easy way, when if you think of mycelium, just imagine if you can grow the mushroom, if someone can cultivate the mushroom, yes, it is, you can get the mycelium.
So anybody that can grow mushrooms is able to extract
because of the mushroom or fruiting body, in terms of technical term, come from the mycelium.
Okay.
And also, mycelium come from the spore. Okay, on the other way, other hand, one spore sputtering and turn is mycelium. If you know the mushroom production process, you should know the what is the mycelium and you know how to produce the mycelium. So it is the mycelium can be produced in Thailand under the easy step production. Okay.
So it can be found in Thailand and it also can be found in nature.
In
nature, right?
Okay. In terms of nature source, you know what Thailand is it located in a hotspot area. We have many, many abundance on biodiversity, such as animal, plant, and also microorganism. Yes, it is fungus. It's counted one of them. We have a variety of mushroom in the nature, in the forest.
Okay.
We can export them and we can get them and isolate them and select them as a fungal candidate to make the mycelium.
So, and are there any challenges to like extracting the mycelium from nature or from, you know, growing mushrooms, for example?
The one of the challenging things for the mycelium technology, one of the creating, you know what, different mycelium source or different fungi being two different mechanical property. At the same time, various process, various rhinocerose residue also resulting in the different mechanical property as well in terms of material size. So that is one of the pain point. We have to reconsider about the what is the raw material that's useful and what kind of condition that's suitable for the yeast mycelium from the specific fungus. And for the last thing is what kind of process that we can adapt, we can modify the process that suitable for the both target mycelium and also for the target substrate that's for suitable or not. This is research and development need to be done before to using the mycelium technology process as well.
So despite it being readily available, it could be found in the forest, you still need to have the knowledge and the technology to know what type of mycelium is appropriate for the project that you want to do.
Actually, we still ongoing research on many target and also the future innovative mycelium-based composite material in the lab scale. And one of the our pain point, we try to improve on the the mechanical property in terms of material size. Because sometimes some product is fragile and breakable. We need something else, but natural, like a substrate for replacement to improve the property.
To strengthen it.
Yes, and this is one of the pain point.
Right, so at this point, it's still being researched in the lab and it's not yet commercially available, but I understand that the material is being used elsewhere in the world.
Yes, of course.
Can you give us some examples of how what is being used to make?
In the abroad or even in overseas, you know what, they have some country, I will give you for 3 or 4 example in the overseas. In USA, for example, the name of company, Ecovative Designs, Microworks, this is the true company in USA. And the Mogu is in Europe. okay, in Asia, for example, Indonesia, my co-technology, they try to turn any waste from agriculture waste into high value added products using mycelium technology.
Okay.
Yeah, to make the any innovation. For example, bio construction process, they can produce like a bio big paneling boards. Coffee structure, like an idea for the future.
Right, right.
And particularly for the eco-innovative design, this is the first world company that's released what the and give the definition term of mycelium. They produce like a packaging made from mushroom. This is the pop-up idea on that time. Yeah.
This is, of course, in reference to the zebras that we see here on the table, which is the zero pollution zebra that we discussed in an earlier episode, that they're made from mycelium as well and are completely biodegradable and decompose a lot faster, especially when compared to the original zebras that people, and these are the zebra dolls that people are using in as votives, right, in offerings in the traditional Thai belief. Now, in addition, in Thailand, for example, what industry do you think could benefit most once, you know, once they're, you're able to scale and use this commercially?
Okay, for in case of zero pollution zebras product here, this is under the prototype scale right now. So in the future, actually, it's, we can do it in for the future. Like us to make them as a mass scale because you know in Thailand our country is depend on the agriculture section
right.
We have the many things from agriculture process and then release the some byproducts such as biomass and also waste from many areas but depend on the which part of country that we get for example in eastern of Thailand we have the many food peel, like a durian peel, mango tea peel. Yes, it is research developments under my skill or even the some who interested in this skill using the mycelium technique can apply in and make them based on the, their own original resource substrate in local products.
When we compare ourselves to other, for example, ASEAN countries, in terms of being able to provide mycelium, like become a source, do we have any advantages over other countries?
In ASEAN, one of the company that we know, my co-technology in Indonesia, they produce like a leather.
Leather, okay. Yeah, so leather some ASEAN countries are using it like on commercial
already. They make like a shoe for mushroom. They like a leather to make the wash. Something like that. Okay, this is already sale, you know. You know, this is the very useful and also this is the current trend in terms of who were very interested in the environment.
Right, like those who don't want to use real leather because they, you know, they don't want to involve animals, right? So it's definitely a good alternative. With that, let's take a short break and we'll be back to talk more about mycelium. Welcome back, you're watching Thailand Today. We continue our discussion about mycelium, a green material made of a network of fungal threads. And time now to look at the material itself. So I think basically to clarify, you know, the understanding of what mycelium is and what does it look like, can you show us?
Again, it's like a wasp of fungus, like worse.
Right.
You can see.
It basically looks like cotton.
Yeah, it seems to be like a puffy cotton.
Can we show it to the, yes.
Cotton, okay, in white, in some cream in color. But the difference is depend on the what kind of the fungus that produce in terms of color, the external morphological characteristic.
What's the structure of this?
Structure in size, they contains chitin. Chitin is a biopolymer inside. May I give in beef for chitin? Mm-hmm. In nature, chitin come from the animal.
Okay.
Like a chim, crab. Okay, when if you or anyone like a seafood, okay, you burn it up, you get the color in orange or in red. This is the chemical from the chitin. So on the other hand, this is chitin from fungi. Yes, the chitin look like a spider web, you know. But you know, spider web make very very systematic patterns.
So this one is in its natural form. There's nothing.
Form.
Nothing has been done to this. So you can, if you take a closer look, this looks exactly like cotton, right? This is natural form.
Of actually, for this one, this is the man-made for showing.
Okay,
we can open this out. Okay, just we make to show how the mycelium look like.
Okay.
For
this one is for just for show. Yeah.
My right hand side here, this is the real one.
This is the real one.
This that's fully grown on the synthetic media.
Okay. And how are they stored?
Oh, actually, one of the easy way, we can culturing and transform this one into the sorghum grains.
Like where do you have to store them?
For the solace technology, this is low tech technology. You can use the sterile technique step. You can make the carbonates and just make sure that there are any air outside, because outside they have a lot of microorganisms, to make sure that this is the sterile techniques or acidic techniques in terms of microbiology. So for sorghum grain, just sterile technique in very very high temperature to make sure that sorghum they don't have anything from
so
the
that
outside.
It's sterilized,
yes, sterilized, yeah. And after they cool it out, just transfer and pick it up to the sorghum grain. This is easy step for the short term sterilization process. And also one of the best thing is easy to use for the make the mycelium. This is the conventional steps how to store the mycelium in terms of easy way. For this is for applied for the farmer, for the one who don't know any technology at all. And for the last thing, may I recommend, we use the standard freezer mostly under minus 20 degrees Celsius. This is the standard step to visit them.
Now, in terms of creating something that would be able to replace plastics, because mycelium is biodegradable, what are the chances? What's the potential of creating something from mycelium that replaces
to
plastics?
To use the fungal technology, or I mean mycological technology, in overseas, obviously, in abroad, I always mention about the innovative design, because this is the first company who released the mycelium based composite products in terms of environmental design and also innovative product as well. Innovative design, they try to turn agriculture waste or any biomass products, but based on rare country, right? And turn it to the innovative mycelium composite, or we call fungal based composite or mycological innovation composite product as well. This is the solution, direct replacement for the plastic based packaging, such as styrofoam and polystyrene, something like that. These two type of plastic have been widely used as the single-use plastic in the current time.
Yeah. Okay, so it is being used to replace single-use plastics elsewhere in the world already.
Yes.
Okay. What's this one? Is it derived from that?
Okay. May I give some information? This is the mushroom.
Okay.
When you ask me about the mycelium, actually, mycelium come from the one spore turn it into mycelium. One mycelium stick together, turn it to complicated mycelium. Sometimes we call hypha or hyphae. Okay, hypha, hyphae mycelium is in gauze is the same meaning. Okay, if this one take more time in term of laboratory in incubation and techniques, okay, some fungi turn it to the fruiting body. This is just the example of the one target mushroom. Yeah, this is the pattern, how step from spore turn it to mycelium, and okay, mycelium turn it to the fruiting body or mushroom. Yeah.
So from this goes to that?
Yes, of course.
Okay. Now, green products or environmentally conscious products have been increasingly gaining popularity among consumers. What other green projects does biotech have in the pipelines?
Oh, actually, we have many projects that we do. We try to produce many bio-based material using the fungal mycelium techniques, and also we try to choose the different kind of the lignocellulose that are available in Thailand. Okay, and one of the key things that I may mention, we try to improve the mechanical property in terms of material science. This is one of that we are on do research, and absolutely we not do it by our team. We have collaborative with the MTechs, also the another research institute in under the NASA as well. So who good in the material side to support this work as well. Yes.
How important is biotechnology for everyone's future?
Biotechnology, okay.
How would you define it at first?
In terms of biotechnology, they have many applications in various fields. For example, medical biotechnology, food biotechnology, agriculture biotechnology, and industrial biotechnology, for instance. So yes, of course, mycelium technology, this is counted one of them in terms of using mycelium technology to apply in this field. So biotechs under NASA and STDA, use biotechnology as the powerful tool for the research and for development, and also to make any innovation so that we can obtain the scientific output and also innovative outcome, as well as various positive impacts which are social, economics, and also environments. This is the overall, the concept based on my idea.
So that's extremely important for all of our future.
Yes.
Now, in your opinion, what do you hope will become of mycelium in Thailand? How do you hope it, what industry do you think would benefit the most from using it?
Apart from my expertise, we have many collaborations, either inside NASA or outside NASA, to help together. And we can work together closely in terms of any east or any specific project. You know what Thailand, we are the agriculture section. So many agriculture waste, and also so many biomass. For example, some factory can return back into the electrics. Some company can return the agriculture waste into the high value added product, such as fertilizer, and for the board composite. But this technology is one of them. We hopefully, if you interested things on this technology, just contact us. We will be the good partner. And lastly, I hope that mycelium or even mycelium technology based on our bioresource of country is gonna be one of alternative solution for our future.
Okay, that's wonderful, and we're all excited to see when it could actually be used on a large scale. So if thinking about mycelium, then think about biotech, right?
Yes, of course.
Thank you so much,
Dr.
Nathan Wood Kapunka. And there you have it from Biotech's Dr. Natawut Bunyun. And that's it for our show today. We broadcast every Friday at 11 p.m. on NBT2HD and every Saturday at 9:30 p.m. on NBT World, as well as live on our NBT World YouTube channel. Don't forget to like and comment on our Facebook page, Thailand Today Online. I'm Pran Chirakosan. Swatthikha.